Do you lean on one leg? Do you sit more on one butt cheek than other? Do you sit with a wallet in your pocket? Do you sleep on the same side? Or holding a baby on one side of the hip? Are you walking or jogging or running on a slanted road or a track that is a little bit tilted? Do you have a flat foot? Friends, you need to question yourself. It's also important to correct any bad posture so the problem doesn't come back. Friends, sometimes the root cause is in our habit patterns and you need to just resolve it. Because of these habit patterns, over time, some muscles become weak and some muscles become tight. It's also known as tissue adaptation. A lateral pelvic tilt or uneven hip occurs when one hip is higher than the other. So, if you have your right hip higher, your right shoulder would be depressed. This can cause some muscles to tense or tight, while others get weak or loose. When the right or the left hip is high, you have weak gluteus medius and TFL, that is tensor fasciae latae. You have tight QL and adductors. When the right or the left hip is low, you have tight glute medius and TFL, and weak QL and adductors are elongated. So, if you wish to correct your lateral pelvic tilt, you need to select those asanas that can strengthen and stretch those muscles. So, first you should check which hip is higher and accordingly work on the set of asanas. Massage can help relax the tense muscles, and daily asana practice can help strengthen the weak ones and stretch the tight ones. So let's start with the asanas. This video will focus on the right hip higher and the left hip lower. Friends, in case you have a left hip higher, then do the exact same exercise but on the opposite side. So a recap, when the right hip is high, we have weak gluteus medius and TFL and tight QL and adductors, and our left hip is lower, that means we have tight gluteus medius and TFL and weak QL and adductors. So let's start with the yogic asanas. Follow me with a standing position. Now we are focusing on the standing postures. So follow me, right? So once again, there's a gap between the feet. You're standing tall, the abdomen is engaged, there's a chin tuck and the shoulders are down, right? So the first one is calf raise. So just giving a little bit of warm up and getting mentally and physically prepared. So tall yourself, chin tuck, and now with a gentle smile, inhale, lift up. Exhale, take it down. Two, inhale, lift up. Exhale, take it down. Three, inhale, lift up. Exhale, take it down. Four, last one, five. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, take it down. Fine, so that was your five counts. You can make it 10 also, 15 also, depends. Now we are focusing on Virbhadrasana 2, but only on the right side. So, I just take the legs wide apart, anything that is comfortable to you. So don't take it too much wide, right? Now, keeping it wide, tall yourself. Now take the left leg out, external rotation. Now, you can take it a little bit more down. See that the knee and ankle is on one line. Fine, keep that abdomen engaged. Tall yourself and a chin tuck. Now remember, the warrior two is like this, but right now we are focusing on keeping the hands, because so what is the focus? We need to stretch our adductors, that is tight. And at the same time, what we are doing is we are strengthening the quads, we are strengthening the gluteus medius. Fine, so tall feeling, neck and shoulders relaxed. You can try to go more down, down, down. Feel the nice stretch on your adductors. tall feeling and see, can I check that knee ankle one line? Perfect. Breathe in and breathe out. Keep that core engaged, tall feeling. Inhale and exhale. Come back slowly. Relax yourself. Give some time. Let the muscles relax and breathe. We are doing it twice. So once again, so from here, you just take the left leg out and stretch it down, 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 down. I need a lot of good stretch on the adductors and try to feel the working hard on the quadriceps and the gluteus medius. Keep that core engaged, tall feeling. And so avoid forward bend. Try to go a little bit more back, tall feeling. Inhale and exhale. Activate that back leg. Activate that back leg. And keep the weight in center. And come back slowly. Step by step. And relax yourself. Now we are focusing on Virabhadrasana 3, also known as a Warrior 3. But remember, only the right side. Okay, so what's happening? This posture strengthens the gluteus medius once again. So I keep myself tall, keep that abdomen engaged. And now, because I want to strengthen my right glute, I take the left leg forward. So I just make more space. Now, keep the pelvic facing front, right? Now, lift up. Keep that abdomen engaged. I don't want an anterior tilt. So I need the core engaged so that the pelvic is neutral. Okay? Lift up, light touch. Keep that core engaged. Chin tuck. Neck and shoulders relax. Lift up. Now, remember, a Warrior 3 is with the hands straight, but I am skipping that out because the focus is on strengthening the glutes, okay? So tall feeling. If you are comfortable here, try to hold it here. Keep that core engaged. But slowly and steadily as you practice, you have to go forward gently, balance yourself, keep that core engaged, glutes are active. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale. Come back slowly, relax. Fine, right now the breathing is not that important. If you skip the breathing, that's fine. But let there be a normal, continuous, yogic breathing. One more time, let's repeat it. So tall feeling, chin tuck, hands on the hip. I take my left leg forward. Now inhale, lift the leg up. And now keep holding that posture, focusing on your breathing. Now there is a continuous breath. Inhaling and exhaling. And exhale, come back slowly, relax yourself. So friends, you are doing it twice. You can hold it for 15 to 30 seconds to whatever duration that you feel you are comfortable with, but only on your right side. So friends, after the standing position, we are doing a kneeling position. So we are focusing on stretching the left TFL. So I put my knee on the cushion so my knee doesn't hurt. Okay, so I'll just space out a bit. And now I take my right leg forward. Fine. So now what's happening? Because the left hip is lower, we are trying to stretch the left TFL. So once again, keep that abdomen engaged. Okay. Tall feeling. Pelvic is neutral. Chin tuck. Keep the hands on the hip. And now first try to stretch a little bit more forward. You're trying to stretch the hip flexors, the iliac and the psoas, and at the same time there's a nice stretch happening on the TFL. Now to increase the stretch more, lift the left arm up and then exhale, inhale, chin tuck, exhale, feel that nice stretch to the sides, inhale, three more, inhale, exhale, inhale, come back, exhale. Inhale, come back. Last one, try to hold it longer, deeper the stretch more. Inhale, exhale. Now hold it there, deepen the stretch. Hold it there, 15 to 30 seconds, whatever you're comfortable with. Keep that abdomen engaged. Feel the nice stretch over here. Fine, breathe, breathe, breathe. Inhale, come back. Let the arms go down and relax yourself. So that was a stretch for your TFL. Now we are focusing on supine position, that is lying down on our back. Now friends, let's lie down on our back in Shavasana. So gap between the feet, chin tuck, your palms are facing up and allow the body to relax. Now friends, if your head is going like this, then what you need to do is you just add a small cushion or one or two books. So instead of this, where the vision is going behind, your vision comes towards the ceiling. Okay, so give a gap between the feet, allow the body to relax. Your face muscles and jaws are relaxed, loosen the neck and shoulders, and observe your breathing. Shavasana. Inhaling and exhaling. Shavasana helps you to relax mentally and physically. So giving some time, allowing the body to relax, and connecting with your breath. Breathe. And now we are getting into Ardha Pavan Mukthasana. So both feet are together. Okay, palms are facing down. Now with the next inhale, I bend my right knee and take it up to the chest. Remember to have the chin tucked, my shoulders are relaxed. And now inhale, interlace your fingers. Exhale, take your knee gently towards chest. Check that your face muscles and jaws are relaxed once again. And remember, you're not pushing, right? You're just doing it in a very relaxed way. Focusing on the breath, enjoying that nice stretch you can feel on the gluteal region, the stretch on the lower back. And it's a nice way to also warm up the posterior part of the body. Inhaling and exhaling. Inhaling and exhaling. Remember to have that chin tucked. Check that the neck and shoulders are relaxed. Remember, you're not pushing so harder that the shoulders come up. Okay? Relax it. Now inhale, let the arms go down. Exhale, stretch your legs out and relax in Shavasana. So give just one or two breaths to relax in Shavasana. So no hurry. Try to be in the present moment. Try to be in the here and now. Relax. Now both feet together. And now slowly bend your left knee and take it up to the chest. Keep the right leg active. Okay? Inhale, interlace your finger on the knee. And exhale, take the knee gently more near to the chest. Very comfortable, very relaxedly, and you're focusing on deep yogic breathing where the abdomen and chest both expand simultaneously. Inhaling and exhaling. Nice long deep breathing. Make it so relaxed that it's effortless. You're not pushing and reaching anywhere. Just do it as relaxedly as possible. It's a nice passive stretch. You can hold it for 15 to 30 seconds. Then inhale, let the arms go down. Exhale, stretch your legs out. And relax in Shavasana. Just observe your breath. Be in the present state of here and now. And now, let us do with both legs together. Now remember, you can repeat the Ardha Pavan Mukthasana twice and thrice, okay? That's completely fine. Now, bending the right and left, okay? Now, take the right knee to the chest, the left knee to the chest. And hold this position for some time. Let the abdomen work. Let the abdomen be active. Check the neck and shoulders, relax. There's a chin tuck. Inhale. Interlace the fingers and exhale, gently take the knee towards the chest, very slowly, very relaxedly, okay? No force. It should be so gentle that the muscles will give way for the stretch. You don't have to really force it. You don't have to push it and, you know, reach like this. No, we don't need any dynamic stretch, okay, or ballistic stretch. What we need is very comfortable, very slowly, and enjoy your breathing. And the best part about Pavan Mukthasana, also known as Apanasana, is it's a nice movement in the pelvic diaphragm. Just hold it, and it's good for digestion also. Breathe in and breathe out. Now if you are comfortable, you can also lift the head up. Lifting the head up engages the core more strongly, so it depends. But if you have any cervical issues, then don't do it. Breathe in and breathe out. Now
Inhale, let the arms go down, and exhale one by one. Just relax yourself, observe your breath. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. And now we are focusing on Setu Bandhasana, that is a bridge pose. So the palms are to the sides. Now don't take the feet too forward, or don't take it more in like this, okay, because there is a lot of compression on the knee. So make it in a very comfortable length so that, you know, it's a little bit straight. Palms are facing down, okay, and don't tighten it, relax it. Now as you inhale, first of all I need that you tighten the abdominal muscles. I don't need an anterior tilt of the pelvis and then you are lifting it up. So keep that abdomen active, chin tuck, shoulders relax. As you breathe in, now remember, I don't want this. The body should not go back, okay? The weight of the feet, you're lifting up straight. So inhale, lift it up slowly. Keep that core engaged. Keep that glutes engaged, okay? Now this posture is nice to strengthen your gluteal muscles, right? And the knees are pointing forward. Breathe in. The glutes are strongly active. The arms, the palms can be facing up also. Check the neck and shoulders relax. Keep that core engaged. And now focus on breathing deeply. Inhale. Exhale. Remember, you're focusing on yogic breathing, not belly breathing. Okay, we don't want a belly breathing. We need the abdomen and the chest expand simultaneously. So yogic breathing. You can lift up more higher, you can lift up more higher, tighten the glutes and exhale, take it down slowly. Keep that core engaged as you take it down and relax yourself. Now friends, you can repeat Setu Bandhasana twice, thrice, whatever, you know, duration you are comfortable with. Okay, so relax yourself, observe your breath, breathe. And now we are focusing on Ek Pada Setu Bandhasana, that is bridge pose only with one leg, okay? So here what you're trying to do is we take both feet together, okay, fine. Now inhale, lift the hip up. So once again tightening the glutes, tall feeling. And now I take my left leg in a tabletop position. So there is more stronger activation of my glute muscle, buttock muscles. I hold it there. I can hold it for 5 to 10 seconds. It's quite difficult. Breathe. And take it down slowly. Relax yourself. Now friends, when you're doing an Ek Pada Setu Bandhasana, you can might have a catch here. So just release the leg and once again try it out. Okay, we are only focusing on the right leg, right? Once again, inhale, abdomen is engaged, pelvic is neutral, chin tuck, lift up slowly. Keep that core and the abdomen, the glutes engaged. So the abdomen and the glutes are engaged. You lift up. Okay, then you lift the left leg up. Hold that position. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhaling and exhaling. So you can see I've been vibrating, such a, you know, strong posture. And take it down slowly. Relax yourself. Give some time, rest. You can straighten the legs out and relax. Or you can bend the knees. That's completely up to you. Observe your breathing. Now we are focusing on twisting of the spine, right? So you can keep the arms straight or you can take the hands behind the head, chin tuck once again, fine. Keeping the hands behind the head will be good because that little bit of support to the head. Both feet together, okay? Now here we are trying to stretch the IT band and the TFL of both the legs, right? So both the hips basically. Now I take my left leg on the right, I cross it, okay? Now inhale, exhale, I'm twisting to my left hand side and I can take my head to the right hand side completely. Now here I can hold it for 30 seconds to a minute and I focus on breathing deeply, the yogic breathing. You can keep your eyes closed, enjoy that nice stretch. Be mindfulness of the stretch. How the stretch is feeling, it's tight. You know, it's be aware of everything. It's a wonderful stretch. But remember, you're not forcing anything. Let gravity do the job. So 30 seconds to a minute, whatever duration you are comfortable with. You can always pause the video, do it twice and thrice, and then once again continue, right? Inhale, come back. And release. Relax for one or two breaths, you're not in a hurry. Okay, so remember, always pause the video whenever you want to do twice and thrice, yeah? You take the right leg up and cross it on the left, right? That's the position. Okay, so inhale here, chin tuck. Now exhale very slowly and gently. Try to absorb that stretch as you move. As you move, enjoy the journey of going down, right? And you can take the head to the opposite side. That's a wonderful stretch. Focus on your breathing. Inhale and exhale. Remember that you can hold it for 30 seconds to a minute. And this is stretching your TFL also the IT band. A little bit stretch on the glutes, a little bit stretch on the QL. Come back in center and relax yourself. Now stretch your legs out and you can just relax in Shavasana for a few breaths. Okay friends, after Shavasana, we are focusing on Supta Kapotasana. That is also known as a reclining pigeon pose. So, once again, you bend both the knee, the feet is flat on the floor, okay? Now, take your left leg on the right, figure four position. And now, inhale, exhale, take the right knee to the chest, chin tuck. Take the left hand, right hand, hold it, chin tuck. Inhale and now very slowly and gently feel the nice stretch on the glutes. Face muscles and jaws are relaxed and don't forget the gentle smile when you do it. Be very relaxed, be very comfortable. You don't have to force yourself. Just lovely, in a very loving way, just do it very slowly and gently. You can keep your eyes closed to be more aware. No force. Very slowly, neck and shoulders are relaxed, face muscles are relaxed. And then with the next inhale, let the arms go down. And with an exhale, very slowly, use your core and down. Relax yourself, give some time to rest, breathe. And now we're trying to stretch on the right side of the glute, okay? So, take the right ankle on the left knee, fine. Now, use your core and with an inhale, take the leg towards you. Exhale. Now, inhale, interlace it. Chin tuck, neck and shoulders relax. Inhaling, exhaling very slowly. That's a wonderful stretch. I can feel a little bit more tightening on the right side. Just enjoy the stretch. Remember, don't fight with the muscles. Don't fight for the stretch. Just do it very relaxedly, very lovingly. Deepening the stretch, enjoying the stretch. And don't forget your smile, right? You have to really enjoy it. It takes time for the muscles to give way. They don't defend when you do it in a very loving way. They will defend if you try to push it and reach somewhere, God knows where you want to reach. Just relax, be in the present state of here and now. And release very slowly. So inhale, let the arms go down. And exhale very slowly, use your core and relax yourself. Now, you can gently straighten your legs out and relax in Shavasana. So after every asana, give 2 to 3 breaths of a break in between and relax. So friends, that was the postures on the supine position, that was lying down on our back. let us do it on the abdomen, that is a prone position.
So lying down the abdomen means you are working on the right glute. Remember, our right glute was weak, we need to strengthen it. So both the legs pointing straight, the forehead is resting on the backside of the palms, and remember to keep the core engaged. Now shoulders are relaxed, and now as you breathe in, you are lifting the right leg up straight without bending the knees. Now the left leg is active and straight, it's not loose. Now both the hips are anchored on the floor. You don't need a position where the hip is going like this. So hip is anchored on the floor. So from here lift up, hold the position for some time. And exhale, take it down slowly. Observe for a few breaths. Now once again, as we inhale, straighten the leg, toes are pointing, knees are locked, and lift up. Inhale and exhale, you can take it down slowly. Relax yourself. Observe your breath. And now from there, let us get into a child's pose, that is Balasana. Now from here, come back gently. And now, if you remember, our left QL was weak. We need to strengthen the left QL. So I will be lying down on my left forearm, not on my right forearm, because remember the right QL was tight, we need to stretch it, but your left QL was weak, we need to strengthen it. So I lie down on the side, my forearm, my legs are straight. Now if you want, it is difficult, if this you find it difficult, then I will recommend you to bend the knee and lift up slowly. Hold that position, tall yourself. That's completely fine. Okay, you can take the elbows a little bit more in. Keep that core engaged. Feel your left QL working. Hold that position, chin tuck, breathe in and breathe out. You can hold it for 10, 15 or 30 seconds. Tighten the core, engage the glutes, hold that position. Now, if you feel that you're getting better, then you can straighten the leg, fingertips apart, lift up, and hold that position for a few breaths that you're comfortable with and take it down. So this is where you're strengthening your left QL. And now let us sit in a cross-leg position, tall feeling. Our left QL was weak, but our right QL was tight. So what we need to focus on, stretching the right QL. So once again, I'm sitting tall, my core is engaged, there's a chin tuck, my shoulders are relaxed. I keep their fingertips on the floor. Inhale, lift up, and exhale, I go laterally to the sides very slowly. I can feel that nice stretch. I can observe that breath, breathe in and breathe out. I can hold it for 15 to 30 seconds, giving a nice stretch on my QL, that is quadratus lumborum. Both the buttocks are on the floor, my neck and shoulders relax. Inhale, I come back. Exhale, I take it down and relax. So you can repeat this posture 2 to 3 times, stretching your QL muscles. And now, if you remember our glutes, what was happening? Our right glute was weak, but our left glute was tight. Okay, so what we need to focus on is stretching our left glute, that is tight. So we are doing an Ardha Matsyendriyasana, where I straighten both the legs out. Okay, now I want to focus on the stretch on my left glute. So I bend that knee. Okay, try to keep the spine straight. So if you want, you can sit on a bolster or a pillow or something, so the spine is more straight. I don't want your spine like this. Okay, keep it tall. Now your left leg goes on the right. Okay, now I'm trying to do is keep it straight. Take that knee and push it towards the chest and feel that nice stretch. Okay. Now keep your hands at the back and try to pull that knee towards the chest and give that stretch. You're getting a nice twist and there's a nice stretch happening in your glutes. So holding that position, observing your breath, and stretch out and relax yourself. So friends, these were the set of the asanas on the right hand side. So if your right hip is higher and the left hip is lower, you need to focus on these asanas. Friends, that was it for today. Thank you very much for watching my video. Take care. Keep smiling. Namaste.